Hey guys, so today I have a makeup tutorial for you. Just doing like my kind of go-to look, and I just wanted to show you this from start to finish. I am a rosacea patient, so maybe it's also interesting to see how I do my makeup and make my skin look like this instead of really red. Let's get started. We're gonna do my first get ready with me. I just love beauty videos. People just make it look so easy to film these videos. Always thought I was quite confident. I thought I would just easily do it as well, but it's not that easy. Just gonna like do it anyway because I just love when people share their makeup with me. I've been doing a lot of my own makeup for photo shoot. Anyway, let's just jump into the video. So I have a big spot here that I want to get rid of. I always start with this. This is my favorite cream. I actually have rosacea, so I think it's good if I can put this also in the description of the title, because there are not many tutorials I think about people with rosacea. This is actually a cream that I use as well for my rosacea. I thought this is, I don't know if you see it on camera, but it's like really red. This is also, it's not really a spot, but this is something you get. I mean, you never know with rosacea. They don't really go away, they just turn into little scars. So I have a few concealers. This is the Born to Glow in shade Vanilla. I use it on my mouth a lot. I have it, tried it in many colors, but this is definitely my favorite. This pot, and I don't want to look at it all the time. Shall I go? Yeah, I'm gonna go with this one from Clinique. I have this in two different colors. I have Ivory and Flex. I'm gonna mix this with the Born to Glow. I'm not gonna use this other one on my forehead, but I'm gonna use this one. Always a red nose because I'm allergic to literally everything. Also a lot of makeup, and even this. It also could be the cream, because sometimes, like, I'm also allergic to apples and stuff like that, and it could be that they use some of this in the skin food. As you can see, my under eyes are really dark because they're very hollow. Yes, I do sleep enough. This is the blessing of jeans. I was thinking of doing filler in them. They look like slits in my face. It makes me look really sad and old and I don't know. But I'm too scared to do filler, I think, because it can move and it can even like get you looking lumpy. And another big risk is you can get blind from. Not a risk I'm willing to take, at least not yet. I'm gonna try to bounce the light with this little baby. I got the Flawless Filter from Charlotte Tilbury. Hollywood Flawless Filter for Superstar Youth Glow in color Fair. I got this in the small one because I didn't really know if it was gonna be any good. But I did want to try it because who doesn't want to have a youth glow? I did it one time under my foundation, but it wasn't that nice. It kind of ruined my foundation, if that makes sense. And I do need the coverage, so, but with my skin it's always very difficult to do a really nice foundation when you don't see any pores or rosacea. how glowy I am. So pretty. So I'm using setting powder. I use the one by Catrice. It's very cheap, but it's very good. It's similar to the Chanel powder, just a fraction of the price. I have my wrinkles back here because I don't have Botox. Now I can do this. My eyes actually look bigger. I want to put a little bit more of the flawless filter because I just am in love. For brows, I use this little genius. This is the NYX Micro Brow Pencil. I'm brushing very, very lightly. Now I'm gonna do little hair strokes. And I literally have to do that from top to bottom because the other way around is a little bit hard. So, and then I brush it upwards. This is my new palette from Lime Crime. These are the colors. I was looking for a palette that has a lot of browns and nudes in it. Yeah, I don't really have that one yet. First I'm going in with Flash. Look how that color looks. Immediately it's so stunning. It's like a little bit of a curly nude. Very soft. And then I'm gonna put in this color Virgin. This is 217 from MAC and this is 219. The perfect brush for under your eyes. So I'm gonna do this with Flash as well. Now I'm picking up nude. Trusty hula that I always use. I love this brush. Drag it up a little bit, just very lightly. Forehead, a little bit in my hair, a bit darker. Always put it here. My favorite color ever. Now I'm just gonna do one more like this. Hold my little Jacquemus. Favorite part, lips. This is Sore from MAC. I feel like I'm not focused because I'm also filming this and I'm not focused, so it's super hard to do both of the things. Now to the fun part. So we're going to do gloss over it. The Dior Diorama that I just bought for my birthday. Just thought it was so beautiful. My favorite colors. You can wear it all day. All day, every day. And I'm just gonna put it over here. Okay, I'm missing something. I'm gonna do 1484, this one, in the corner of my eye. And do you know where I'm going today? Nowhere. So this is mid, back, mineral line, and soft and gentle. So, here we have my favorite look. This is kind of my go-to look. Yes, this is what I always wear. Almost every day. Truthfully, you'll be all mine, all mine, all mine. I hope you like. liked this video. It was something different than what I do normally. I hope I will do more videos like this. I want to do a lip swatch video with all my MAC lipstick. Look at this. And there's more. These ones. And these are my nudes. Just maybe I will do a full face of Charlotte Tilbury. Oh, let me know what you think. Give it a thumbs up if you like it. See you in the next one.